front of my office and get the iPad that's off the desk.
Thank you. It's Jesus, light of the world. Pull down that red slide just a little bit. Thank you. Good. That takes care of the feedback. Well, I trust that the Lord has been good to you. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. And this speaks of his second coming,
when he is coming to not just be Jesus the teacher, Jesus the miracle worker, Jesus who's trying to show us to point the way to the kingdom, but he's coming back to establish that kingdom and be the wonderful counselor. He's coming back to be the king of the world, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. He's coming back to put an end to all war. It's going to be wonderful. It says about this Prince of Peace in John chapter 1, verse 4 and 5. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not understood it. The darkness has not understood it. But I'm thankful that Jesus, being the light of the world, Scripture tells us plainly that he is the light of men. And I've had this type of discussion so frequently with people, even with people lately, that they don't understand that Jesus is the light, and the light for all mankind. This universalism, this many roads to heaven, and you worship Jesus, and I will pray to Allah, and I will chant to Buddha, I will bring an offering to Krishna and Vishnu, says the Hindu, and so on and so forth. This concept of many roads to heaven is a false one. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is the light of the world. Let that resonate deep within your hearts. And don't be indoctrinated by the stuff of the world. What is darkness? We say the light shines in the darkness. That light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. What is darkness? And as it speaks here, in the context in which it's speaking, the context is the idea of darkness being the absence of light, or the absence of truth, or the absence of Jesus. People were living in darkness, and the great light has dawned. Jesus is the light.
Yes, he is.
And if you have no Jesus, you have no life. That saying is, no Jesus, no light. But then you'd say, no Jesus, and no light. K-N-O-W. He is the light. And one of the properties of light is that one of the things that light does, it illuminates your eyes so that you can see.
Yes.
If people want to see, and I think a lot of people do want to see. There are plenty who don't. If people want to see, show them Jesus, because he's the light. See, this is one, and I tell you this because this is a common sense, logical reason why you should tell people about Jesus. Because he's the light. Mm-hmm. Hold the light in front of their eyes. And if they have hearts that really want to see, they will see. And the wonderful thing about this light is a person. Okay, now I can turn on the lights here. The lights will shine and chase away the darkness. As I dim the lights, the shadows come in. Keep your light shining brightly. chase away the shadows. The one thing about this light that we're speaking of, this light is a person, and this light loves. It is the love of God that sent Jesus into the world. You know the scripture, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. It's the love of God that sent him. He sent him because people were walking in thick spiritual darkness. And they still are. They still are. You know, in those days, paganism was rampant. Paganism still is. And the idea of living for yourself, living for one's appetites, that's paganism for sure. People are still walking in a great spiritual darkness, and the Lord calls this dark place of the soul the land of the shadow of death. Yes. And what we're reading there in Isaiah. Oh my goodness. Okay, and hear that again. The Lord calls this place of spiritual darkness the land of the shadow of death. That means that people who are walking in this darkness, people who don't have Jesus, people who don't know your Jesus, are on their way to hell. I wish it wasn't so. I wish it wasn't like that. You know, people want there to be many roads to heaven. And you believe what you believe and be at peace with that, and I'll do the same with what I believe. But listen, people who don't have Jesus are on their way to hell. They are in the land of the shadow of death. And it is the love of God sent to liberate them. Show the love, shine the love of God. Oh yes, shine into the darkness. This love, this light loves, and this light liberates. The darkness is the place where the prisoners are held. In darkness, knowledge is kept from them. In darkness, hope is kept from them. I guess, and they say that's one of the horrible things about hell, is there is no hope. We can bring them hope. We have hope living in us. They begin to see the darkness as the only reality and don't realize that they could have something else. This light drives away darkness in our souls. You know, before we were saved, we walked in that darkness. That's where we lived every day. But we remember this, how Scripture says in the book of Hebrews, that he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness. The dominion of darkness. That place where darkness rules over them. Shine the light for them. Tell them about your Jesus. In your everyday life, and with your words, tell them about your Jesus. This light drives away the darkness from our souls. And as I talk about this aspect right here of the light, that it drives away the darkness from our souls, be honest with the Lord. And let us open every compartment in our lives to let that liberating light shine in. Too often, we can tend to compartmentalize our lives. A number of compartments in our lives, and we let the light of the Lord shine into this one and this one and this one, but we keep that one closed up. open them all. And the ones that we keep closed, maybe we keep it closed for fear. Maybe we keep it closed because we are simply ashamed to open it. But open every compartment for the Lord. Every single one. This light loves, this light liberates, and this light is from heaven. That's what makes it so tremendous. This is the light of God, though. In 1 Timothy chapter 6, God, the blessed and only ruler, the King of kings and Lord of lords, who alone is immortal and who lives in unapproachable light, whom no one has seen or can see, to him be honor and might forever and ever. Amen. As Paul gives this blessing and benediction as he's talking about God, and you can hear the worship in his voice as he writes these things. God, the blessed and only ruler, the King of kings and Lord of lords, who alone is immortal and who lives in unapproachable light, no man has seen and can see, to him be honor and might forever. I had to read that twice. It was so good. Get the idea that this light that we speak of emanates from God himself. Okay? And every time we see a picture of a heavenly being in Scripture, okay, that being is bright and shining. And this bright shining being, the angels that appeared to the shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flocks by night, they were bright and shining. It says the angels came and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. What does that mean? It means that the angels were shining with the light of the Lord. And listen, and hear this. You shine too. If Jesus Christ is your Lord, if you could just see what your spirit looks like, you shine too. When we have the picture of Jesus taking a few of his disciples with him up onto the Mount of Transfiguration, where Jesus was transfigured before them, and all of a sudden his face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzlingly, brilliantly white. You start to see the Lord for who he is. And there appeared with him Moses and Elijah, also bright and shining, as they stepped out of heaven for a moment to speak with Jesus. You see, this is our heritage. This is what we are about and what we will be as we stand in the presence of the Lord. We will shine. And this light that we have, that we really have, if you can really see yourself, we hold this out as the word of life. We tell people about Jesus. We demonstrate that he is the Lord of our lives. And because of this first Christmas, when Jesus was born and came to earth as a baby, this light lives in us. Because of Jesus who lives in us, The light lives in us. And we shine his light. So go and shine on a lost and dying world that needs him desperately. You know, I watch the news, and we all see it. You watch the news, and there was another shooting, and a guy got killed in a carjacking, and the shooting over here, and you know what I mean? And it's like, it's getting crazier and crazier. If that's I guess that's not a real good proper English word, crazier. I should say more crazy. And it comes to mind how desperately we need Jesus. You know, you look on the internet news, I like the Drudge Report. And it gives you little stuff that happens all over the country, and it's all crazy, from coast to coast. This world needs Jesus. And just as the world needs Jesus so desperately, there is sort of an anti-Jesus pressure aimed at keeping you quiet. Okay? Don't be talking that Jesus stuff. That's the enemy trying to make the rules and impose darkness and keep that light low. Don't shine that light over here. It's darkness trying to take over. No, shine the light. Shine the light. Because Jesus said, that we should shine the light on people who are still walking in darkness. He said, you are the light of the world. He said, now, I want you to see the transition. Jesus, who's the light of the world, came. He lives in us. Now we are the light of the world. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Beautiful, beautiful analogy, Jesus. A city on a hill. When you look off in the distance, looking at the city of the hill, it's all lit up. If you're looking at it at night, you can't hide it. So stop trying to hide it. Let your light shine. It says, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. I thank the Lord for his word. And I'm thankful to Jesus for how he said it, just like this. Okay? He didn't say, go out and preach. Tell everybody, preach, yak. Let me tell you about Jesus. Hey, you! Let me tell you about Jesus. No, don't go chasing people down, smack them with your Bible. He said, let your light shine. You know, again, he starts from the very beginning and compares us to a city on a hill. You can't hide it. So I think the emphasis here is don't try to hide it. Okay? You are the light of the world, so just be yourself. Shine. And if the Lord really lives in your heart, you will shine. Okay? Just don't try to hide. People don't, sitting on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and then put a bowl over it, try to hide the light. No, they put the lamp on a stand. And the lamp just does what it does. It shines and gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds. Okay, there is the shining of your light. There is the shining of your light. It being acted out through your lives. Okay? You go to the grocery store and check out wherever you are. They hand you back too much change. Give it back to them. Be honest. Show people love. Show people love. Let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. So we would say to those who aren't saved, to those who are, I like to call them at times pre-believers, people who have yet to become believers, but they're on their way. Know that Jesus loves and liberates. Amen. Anyway, and for those of us who are following Jesus, hold nothing back from him. Okay, and as I say this, I have checked my own heart. Okay? Hold nothing back from me. Hold nothing back. Open every compartment of your life, of our lives, to his healing light and his cleansing light. You know, that's another neat aspect of light, that it cleanses. I go to the barber shop. And the barber has this little box there that puts out, I guess it's an ultraviolet light. And it has a little blue light shining inside it. In the front of it's open. And he's got about maybe three or four different clippers there. If he stops using this clipper for a second, while he's doing the hair, he'll put it down in there and then pick up another one out of there. Okay. And it is, the light itself is, its purpose is to disinfect. Okay. The light cleanses. The light cleanses. The light of Jesus, the light of the world. And the light heals, which is really probably one of the big reasons that people, Christians, have aspects of their lives or compartments in their lives that they don't want to open to the Lord. It's usually because there's some damage there. That part needs healing. That's why that's just another big reason why we should open that aspect of our lives to the Lord. Because the light brings healing and cleansing. And let's pray as we talk about these things. And as we look to Jesus, let's make sure that every aspect of our lives, every compartment is open. And let us resolve to not hide the light. The light wants to shine, because that's what it does. Just don't hide. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for all of these things. Lord, we thank you for how you care for us.
Lord, we thank you for being the light of the world. Lord, for shining the light that loves and the light that liberates. Lord, for the reality, Lord, that you are the light from heaven. And now that the light lives in us because of you. Lord, help us to follow you. Let us naturally shine the light. Help us to become at ease and very comfortable in just shining the light. Let us demonstrate by our deeds, Lord, that we belong to you. Father, and we thank you. And we praise you. Help us to walk with you daily. Thank you for coming and being the light of the world. And we pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. For this we're thankful. Christmas Day. Couple days ago. And got a chance to get together with the family. And Lord blessed us to have a Christmas dinner and all that sort of stuff. Did a lot of work.
Big Christmas dinner.
Chopping and cutting up stuff. And, you know, it makes me think of a nice Christmas pizza. Okay? From a little seed or something. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So anyway, we are thankful.
That's good.
And let's come forward.